back to basics, personality development. People believe that personalities are something we are born with and something we cannot control or change. While that is true to a certain extent and it makes us unique, personalities can also be developed and molded in an effort to improve ourselves. The word personality is quite a broad term used to describe the combination of qualities or traits that form a person's unique character. Some of these qualities or personality traits can be changed with little bit of effort and a lot of mental strength. Some are obvious, like well-dressed and be well-groomed, while others are a little more subtle. In this episode, we will be looking at 10 tips to help you enhance your personality. Number 1. Keep a firm handshake and good posture. A good firm handshake can go a long way in making a great impression, and along with that, good posture portrays confidence. Number 2. Be open to socialization. The more people you meet, the better your social skills develop, and the better your social skill gets, greater are the chances of you being liked more. So put yourself out there and meet people. Number 3. Stay optimistic and don't doubt yourself. Always try to look at the bright side and maintain an optimistic attitude. This will not only get people to see you as a self-confident person, but it will also help you believe in the best and not doubt yourself and your decisions. Number 4. Be a good listener. The key to an engaging conversation is not talking, but listening and responding appropriately. The more you listen, the more you learn about people and build better connections. Number 5. Live for yourself, not for others. Be honest, sincere, and consistent. This is extremely important since often we let others guide our decisions and feel regret during the outcome. Stop living for others. Understand and believe in what you want. Once you figure that out, be sincere and consistent to yourself, otherwise you will come across as a phony. Number 6. Smile and have good manners. Always remember to smile at people, even if they don't smile back. You feel better looking at someone who's smiling at you than the ones who don't. Also, make sure you maintain good manners with everyone you meet, no matter who they might be. Number 7. Be firm, be assertive, and do not be aggressive. There is a difference between being assertive and being aggressive. Aggression is when the conversation becomes pushy or controlling, and if you feel like you're becoming like that, back off. You should always put your point across, but calmly, assertively, and respectfully. Number 8. Always keep learning. Someone has rightly said, learning is the key to success. And a person who stops learning has stopped living well. There are lots of new things to learn, whether it's from books, or by experiencing new things, or by pursuing a hobby. Also, the fact that you're open to learning makes you a far more attractive and interesting person. Number 9. Be confident, not arrogant. Being confident is good, but being arrogant is terrible. Arrogance is about feeling confident or overconfident based on others' weaknesses or their shortcomings. Confidence is about being self-assured and motivated internally. Be mindful of when you're becoming arrogant and stop yourself. Number 10. Make time for your loved ones and close friends. It seems very difficult many times, but ensure you make time for the ones you really want to spend time with. Time is precious, and it speaks volumes about your personality if you value your time and that of others. These are the 10 tips to help develop your personality. Beside these, one of the most important things to remember is to put down your phone and engage with the people around you. Through the experiences of others and oneself, one can truly learn what their personality is about. Back to basics, bathroom etiquette. Don't you get annoyed at people, men and women, who just don't follow basic manners in bathrooms? Well, now you have a video to show them. Let's understand an interesting and extremely important set of etiquettes which doesn't very often get spoken about. Bathroom etiquette. Bathroom etiquette is extremely important in creating a happier, safer and cleaner environment. Whether you're at home, live with others, are using a friend's bathroom or using a restroom in a public place, you should follow good restroom manners. Here are 10 basic etiquette rules you can follow. Number 1. Always wash your hands. This one is truly a basic. After you do what you do, always remember to wash your hands. Whether at home or at office or at a restaurant. You don't want the germs and bacteria from the toilet to leave with you, so leave them there. Wash your hands. Number 2. When to put the seat up and when to put it down. Good seat manners is a two-step process. If you're using the toilet standing up, lift the toilet seat before you get down to business. Once you're done, use a piece of tissue, wipe up, and then put the toilet seat down and close the lid. For those who are using the toilet sitting down, keep the seat down. Once you're done, wipe the seat and then close the lid. Number 3. Clean as you go and keep it dry. No one wants to be greeted by a dirty and wet bathroom, an unflushed toilet bowl or a drop-filled seat and wash basin. If you've made a mess around the seat, wash basin or mirror, make sure you dab it up with some tissues. Try not to spill water on the floor. It just feels unclean and looks messy. So, once you're done, make sure that you leave the space clean, dry and neat for the next person. Hopefully, they will do the same. Number 4. Close the lid while flushing. This is not a common tip. However, it is more sanitary to close the lid before flushing. Studies show that bacteria can fly out of the toilet when flushed and be flung up to 25 centimeters. So it takes just a second more, but close the lid before you flush. Number 5. If you must spit, at least clean it up. Sometimes we really need to spit. If you really need to, spit in the wash basin as close to the drain as possible and run water after it. Don't let the remnants remain. Number 6. Close and lock the door. There are many of us who do not close the door, especially when it's a really quick in and out. Just take a few seconds and close and lock the door. You don't want to be caught with your pants down, literally. Sometimes in public restrooms, the locks might be broken. So use your hand to keep the door shut. Number 7. Check before you open the door. Following from the previous point, since we know, some people don't close the door or sometimes the latch and lock doesn't work. So let us also be careful going in. Knock first, push very slightly to gauge if someone is there. Don't slam your way in, may not work out every time. Number 8. Avoid the phone and conversations. A restroom is not to be confused with an ordinary public space or a conference room. So firstly, ideally, do not answer and speak on your phone while you are in there, especially in a public restroom, since what you say can be heard everywhere. Secondly, do not carry conversations from outside the bathroom into the bathroom. It is pretty awkward and nobody really wants to talk business while doing their business. So, give everyone their personal space. Number 9. No squatting. If you're not using a squatting or Indian style toilet, do not squat. It is dangerous to both you and the toilet. Also, the chances of you missing are higher. Number 10. Don't flush feminine hygiene products. All women use various hygiene products and need to dispose of them. but please do not flush them down the toilet. Also, do not just throw them away. Wrap them up well and put them in the bin. Just more sanitary that way. So just to sum it up, remember to always, always wash your hands. If you're standing, pick up the seat and then place it down before you leave. Remember to clean as you go and keep it dry. Ideally, close the lid while flushing. If you must spit, at least clean it up. Nobody wants to see that in the sink. Before you get in, check before opening the door, and when you get in, close and lock the door behind you. Avoid the phone and conversations. Don't squat unless it is a squatting toilet. And finally, do not flush down tissues or feminine hygiene products. They've been known to create blockages. So these are 10 tips for bathroom etiquette that you can put into effect from the next time you go to do your business. And make going to the restroom a nicer experience for everyone.